Welcome to the Artist Response to Crisis Exhibit. I am your host, Harrison Love. We're here in the LaGrua Center in Stonington, Connecticut, where we are hosting the Artist Response to Crisis Exhibit, which was originally exhibited at the Velvet Mill Studios in Stonington, Connecticut. The LaGrua Center, located in Stonington, Connecticut, is a nonprofit, I believe, art gallery, which works with nonprofits in some ways. And they originally had a conversation with us about carrying this exhibit over in order to carry on a conversation about the way that arts and nonprofits work with one another. Of course, that is because our exhibit, The Artist Response to Crisis, is sponsored by a Artist Response to Crisis nonprofit, which allows our artists to donate any percentage they choose of the resale value of their work to food banks in Connecticut and nonprofits. And that allows the art buyers as well to be able to make a tax-deductible donation to the nonprofit of their choice and have an artist associate, if they're associated with that nonprofit, they can negotiate the sale of their work that way. So I'd like to briefly tour you through the space and explain each piece. We, along the month of January through February, we're going to have other material which we'll be posting along with this. If you have any questions, you can contact me at love.harrison@gmail.com, or you can contact the LaGrua Center through their website, lagruacenter.org. If you're interested to learn more about ARC and the Artist Response to Crisis and the system through which art in this show can be negotiated for tax-deductible donations to the nonprofit of your choice, please contact ARC at arclove.us, arclove.us. All right. Thank you for joining us. I hope that you're well. I know that we normally are wearing masks, but since I'm alone and keeping 6 foot distance away from the artwork as well, I'm going to tour you through the work very safely here, and in extreme consideration for the time that we live in, as especially because this show in many cases is a response to 2020 and 2021. Although many of the pieces that you're going to see in this exhibit are not only about crisis, the current crisis. Some of them are about the crises that artists have encountered in their lives, or artwork which that was created to address the concepts which are very difficult and bring crisis to our communities. I'm going to go off camera now and show you around the space while I tell you about each piece and what I find interesting about it. Let's begin over here. This piece, entitled The Last Hit, was created in 2012 and is the artist's response to the opioid epidemic in the United States. This is oil on canvas and is approximately 7 feet long by 2.5 feet tall. It is based on the composition The Christ Entombed, made by Heinrich Holbein, a classical reference to the burial of Christ. And the artist chose to evoke the sense of the religious iconography and the hyper-realistic paint strokes in order to make a more than real finish on the character, which is both illustrated, but you can see here that the artist included and hid some elements which indicate the nature of the elements and theme that are being addressed here. This painting, The Last Hit, Oil on Canvas,
2.5 feet tall by 7 feet wide with this wood frame. It also, you may notice that the composition is in itself a casket, or designed after a casket. The original Heinrich Holbein did not include the opening that's here. The artist decided to include the opening to allow the soul of the piece to have an escape path for itself. At least that is the intention that was explained to me. Again, this piece, The Last Hit, is available for $7,000 and was created by artist Harrison Love in early stage of his development and work. This piece, made by Dennis Serine, is called The Eye of the Beholder and is oil on canvas, priced at $5,500. Now, as you may remember from our previous video on the exhibit, this artwork I explained is a departure for this artist that he has done in his own personal search over the past several years as he's expressed his work into a more abstract realm. Dennis Serine's work is classically known and popularly known in this area for his sweeping landscapes of the Connecticut countryside and paintings that he's done live in plein air at Barn Island, a space not too far from here in Stonington. What is so remarkable about this departure for me is that I've seen such startling difference between his old work and his new work. In the next exhibit that we're going to feature his work in, Out with the Old, In with the New, will feature old work from Dennis Serine and new work from him like this. You can find out more about Dennis Serine by going and Googling his name and locating his website and social media on Instagram. Again, this painting by Dennis Serine, Eye of the Beholder, is oil on canvas and is $5,500. This set, which I curated into these windows, is by B.J. Gaynor. And this piece is called Fire of Formation. These paintings, I've learned, are really quite interesting in their medium because the artist B.J. Gaynor uses oil and cold wax on paper to make these pieces. So texturally, they are very, very interesting and not traditional paintings. It's hard to see because of the glass and the glare here, but if you would like to see flat images of this painting or inquire about the more details, you can contact me again at love.harrison@gmail.com or contact the LaGrua Center through their website at lagruacenter.org. This piece, entitled Passageway, is oil and cold wax on paper and is valued at $250 by the artist. This piece, entitled Confusion, oil and cold wax on paper, is also valued at $250. And this piece, Fire of Formation, is also oil and cold wax on paper and is $250. Very reasonably priced for these pieces, and I am sure that the artist would love to sell them as a set if possible. Again, if you have any inquiries about the work, then please contact me at harrisonlove or love.harrison@gmail. This series by Harriet Moore Ballard is a series that she did in response to the COVID epidemic. You can see the Purell bottle in the far left corner. I personally selected this work early from the artist. She believed that she was still working on it, but I believe that this painting is fantastically done and completed. It is a mixed media, a combination of different mediums, both digital in some cases, and collage and oil by Harriet Moore Ballard. I'll show you some of the details of this piece. This piece, entitled Space Out or Breakout, mixed media on canvas, is priced at $3,500. That's $3,500. Harriet Ballard is a well-known artist in the Cleveland, Ohio art scene and currently is in a residency out there. Was unable to make it to this exhibit. However, we are holding and carrying on her work. She is absolutely fantastic. I highly encourage that you Google her name and check out her work. This is another Ballard, brown interior, and is valued at $1,800 by the artist. Harriet actually told me herself that this one is a very interesting combination of mediums because she had this digitally printed, and that is what this actually is not drawn, but digitally printed onto the canvas, and then she applied oil and acrylic on top in different sections in order to create the feeling of depth that is so present in these works. Again, this piece, Brown Interior by Harriet Moore Ballard, is valued at $1,800. Artist Holiday is this artist. Artist also has a studio at the Velvet Mill, along with many of us, and I share a studio on the same floor as Artist, but I've only recently interacted and gotten to know her work. This piece, entitled Hilltop, Oil on Linen, is priced at $500. And what I find interesting, I'm afraid I don't know the story behind this work, are the different combinations of thick and thin oil application as well as dry applications of oil on top of wet in some cases. The painting up front, which is hard to convey via video to you right now, has varying textures, but is also very rich in its application and expresses a hilltop. This painting, also by artist Holiday, is called Servers, and it's mixed media on canvas, valued at $350 by the artist. This too has that interesting application of textures that are here. It's mixed media, so I am assuming that there is collage involved because some of the application, I'm just not sure. It's a wonderful piece. And actually it's rather thickly built, so this just doesn't require a frame, but would probably look stunning in one. Again, this painting, Artist S. Holiday, Servers, is priced at $350. This painting by Raphael Lenoe, I selected personally for the beginning of our collection to the Artist's Response to Crisis exhibit. Although the artist did not experience crisis when he was painting this piece, other than the normal everyday crisis that is life, I wanted it for the show because I believed that it's such a powerful piece and shows a good combination of some of the artist's ability and style. Raphael Lenoe's artwork is stunningly diverse, and he does commissions at the moment, and you can find him on Instagram most times. At Alien Flora, that's his name on Instagram. That's at Alien Flora, and that's Raphael Lenoe. This painting, entitled Dusk, is acrylic on panel and is valued by the artist at $1,500. What you'll notice here is that there's the frisket application of paint, where he must have used tape to get these extremely sharp lines around the skull itself. But then there's a subtlety in the brushed application of the acrylic that he's so well known for in terms of his paintings. This painting, it's interesting that the camera is having trouble focusing on this. When you're looking at it with the human eye, it is just an absolutely stunning combination of colors, similar to pointillism, where you get a color blending that occurs. Again, this piece by Raphael Lino, Dusk, is acrylic on panel and is valued at $1,500. This set of paintings by Terry Banas are available for full donation to the ARC Foundation. That means that the artist has graciously allowed any interested party that would wish to buy one or these as a set for $500 each as a direct donation to support Connecticut Food Banks through the ARC Foundation. And these will be available to purchase through www.arclov.us, as well as through legruacenter.org. This is Terry Banas' series on home, and I'm going to go through each piece. This piece, Warm Friends, acrylic on canvas, is valued at $500, along with all of the other paintings in this set. And these are all depictions of the artist's understanding and investigation of the concept of home while being in quarantine. This piece, Hope Homes, acrylic on canvas, is also priced at $500. You can see here, and I didn't notice, but this is a topographical map of somewhere in combination with some front-facing houses and reference, maybe a reference to water here. Beautiful painting. This painting, Behind Closed Doors, acrylic on canvas, by Terry Banas, also contains, and I only noticed this recently, elements of collage, where she's collaged paper buttons, in my original broadcast, I didn't even notice that this was paper. I thought this was paint. And you can see very clearly that it has the names and stuff written on it. I just didn't notice that at first. And, you know, there are other parts of this, but it's really quite fantastic. Again, this is the Home series by Terry Banas. This painting, entitled Grief is a Bridge, acrylic on canvas, is also valued at $500 by the artist. And you can see here that there's kind of a bridge that's forming over here between different houses. And this is an absolutely wonderful painting. It also contains quite a few of those paper collages that are going on quite interestingly here. Again, this series, Home by Terry Banas, is available for full donated price to the Connecticut Food Bank for $500 each or a set. Do contact me at harrisonlove or love.harrison@gmail.com for more information. We will also be posting some of the information in our comments below. This series by artist Laura Hopkins has been a departure of her recent work, more illustrative than she normally does with these very beautiful, thick paintings that she's known for in Connecticut. Laura Hopkins, this piece is called COVID Outbreak, this mixed media on canvas, priced at $125. You can see that there's an interesting application of ink and watercolor, some oils perhaps. She says that they're mixed media, but it must be on paper. And they are absolutely stunning in person, very difficult to convey via the digital medium because of this video and the reflections off the glass, but I'll do my best. Laura Hopkins, Sisyphus 2020. Valued as well at $125 as mixed media. You can see this stone that perpetually rolls down the hill right here. This piece, Contagious, by Laura Hopkins, is also mixed media on paper. You can see in discussing all three of these pieces, the variations in the artist's departure and investigation with ink. Each one of these pieces is valued at $125, and this work is by Laura Hopkins. This piece by artist Harrison Love is entitled "The Spring Will Come" and was produced in 2020 as a response to the beginning of the pandemic, when other officials were saying that the spring would bring less COVID numbers. And it was intended to be a hopeful message to future generations about waiting for the sun to rise, for the spring to come. It contains several icons of a woman that is asleep by the side of a pond that then awakens and with steam rises up through the air in a dance. You can also see some elements of a factory in the distance and smoke rising up, elements of landscape and the struggle between man's dominion and nature. Again, this piece by Harrison Love, "The Spring Will Come," it's acrylic on canvas and is valued at $1,500. It's about 2 by 2 feet. This piece, entitled "The Celebration," also by Harrison Love, was created in 2020 and is oil on canvas. It's approximately 5 feet by about four and a half feet tall. Just 4 feet, and is oil on canvas. It is entitled "The Celebration." It was originally entitled with an expletive in the title, but the artist chose to remove that expletive to make it more friendly for people. It was made as a response to the idea of the concept of the end of the pandemic, in that at some point, we will all celebrate, like the end of World War II, and try to encapsulate a feeling of joy and release and claustrophobia of figures not standing at 6 feet, but rather combining so closely that they become an amorphous character, like an element or wave, a pattern of nature, not merely just stick figures or drawings of outlines of characters or little squiggles, but intended to be the emotional combination of our collective celebration. Again, this piece, "The Celebration" by Harrison Love, is priced at $3,500. These pieces are made by artist Stuart Chandler. I myself purchased one of Stuart's pieces from the last show. There was a brother to this piece, which had another horse being attacked by a puma, but it was a night scene. So I'm sorry that it's removed, but it belongs in my house now. Again, this is Stuart Chandler, and this is called "Love Bites on Red." Is oil on canvas and is valued at $400. What I've always found really fascinating about Stuart's work is that he's exceptionally modest. He doesn't contact. He's very self-sufficient, lives in his studio or doesn't live in his studio, I don't even know. But even in telling him that I purchased his painting, he hasn't contacted me back. I know he's fine, he's just working in his studio. In any case, this painting, "Love Bites on Red, Oil on Canvas," has a lot of different techniques in scratching, as well as the thick and thin applications of paint. And the paint almost looks old, but I know that this is done in the last year as a response to crisis. So it's just fascinating. But this piece, also by Stuart Chandler, is such a departure in some regards to that style, and is called "The Battle Begins, Number 2." It's also oil on canvas, priced at $350. You can see a person on a tightrope wandering across a field which looks almost to be on fire with light, but at the same time, you see a couple embracing and children and people dancing. And this itself, in its interpretation, from most people that see it, think that it's more aggressive about a world on fire, about depression, about a bunch of things, but it's simply not. It is about the glorification and celebration itself of our uniqueness as a form of battle against the enemies of depression. Again, this piece, The Battle Begins, number 2, is oil on canvas and is priced at $350. This nested series is also carried over from the last exhibit that we did at the Velvet Mill. Lisa Leach is an artist that has been at the Velvet Mill for many years and runs her own studio in which she does these collages and combinations of both paper application and thick and thin applications of acrylic ink and watercolor as well as metallic paints. This series that she did of hands is actually a breakthrough piece that she's done on a study of hands, all related to hope. This piece by Lisa Leach is called Breakthrough and is priced at $250. It's very difficult to try to film these because of the reflections on the glass. But if you have any questions, you can always contact me at love.harrison@gmail.com. But please put in the subject heading the name of the artist and put art in the title so that I know what you're talking about. This is another in the series of The Study of Hands by Lisa Leach. This piece, entitled Co-Creating, is mixed media and oil on archived paper and framed. It's valued at $250. I believe she priced all of these at $250. There's a metallic sheen on the water. You can tell that she really had a lot of fun making this piece. Making the whole series, I bet. This piece entitled What's in Your Hand series. Oh, this is actually called The Light Giver. This one. This is The Light Giver. And this, I'll briefly just from the label for the description. The artist says, Lisa Leach, extraordinary things can be done with whatever we have at hand. We don't have to go far to find the opportunity. Even if our hands are empty, there is plenty we can do with them, not the least of which is healing, communication, and cultural shaping. Again, this piece is The Light Giver, which is going to be mixed media oil on archived paper. This piece, also by Lisa Leach, is called Cleansing. I believe is the final piece in the hand. Oh, no, there's one more. Cleansing, mixed media and oil, is priced at $250. And this too, you can see that she worked in some of the metallics into the paper. Absolutely beautiful. Right. This is the last piece in the hand series that was selected for this exhibit and is entitled, Be the Change You Want to See. This piece, Be the Change You Want to See, is mixed media, oil on canvas, and is more like Lisa's traditional work, which contains so many different mixed medias and paper. See these wrinkles on the canvas are actually formed from paper application and tissue paper in some regards. There's an application, beautiful application of acrylics and oil here, metals, there's metal leaf in it. Really fascinating process. With Spirit Winds Gallery is Lisa Leach's. And if you would like to know more, you can contact me or I can list information about her below. Oh, this piece is also by Laura Hopkins, who made this series over there. I had it separated, and I should have mentioned this, but this is the Shelter at Home, made in 2020. It's pen on paper. It's valued at $195 by Laura Hopkins, and is very different from the others in that this more focuses on her pen abilities, not just the pen and combination paint. Again, Shelter at Home, made in 2020, it's pen on paper, is valued at $195. This piece by artist Tim Love is my father, and this piece is called The Liar's Club. It's oil on canvas, is valued at $4,500, and is the artist's response to the political turmoil that has happened for the past 4 years. But he made this, I believe, in 2015. Again, artist Tim Love, The Liar's Club. You can see this fascinating depictions of these characters, archetypes, and I'm not exactly sure who the person on the top left is, but they're definitely whispering into the ear of what seems to be Mike Pence. The bottom left might be Hillary Clinton, but we all know who the bottom right is. He who shall not be named. This again, The Liar's Club, oil on canvas by artist Tim Love. It's valued at $4,500. I think it is worth noting that today, the artist's work, my father, Tim Love, was nominated for a Pulitzer Prize for his podcast called Discovering Truth, which is also in part his response to the crisis of our age in trying to define what is truth. During the podcast, he's interviewed such notable figures as Jane Goodall, amongst others. These two pieces by Anne Wildley were just delivered earlier today, and I've talked with the artist, and I would like to, there is an accompanying statement that we'll include, but for the sake of brevity, I'd like to just talk about her work. Anne Wildley is a tremendously talented printmaker, and she makes etchings, she's done landscapes, she's just amazing. And she told me, or I've heard, that she made this originally, this piece entitled O-O-H, or O, or Ooh, Child. Well, this is probably Ooh, Child. You know, things are gonna get easy. It's probably based on that song. And this is a G. Clay fine art print valued at $300. Now, Anne told me that when she made this work, that it originally didn't have the mask, but that she went back in with metallics and was able to put in a gold leaf mask on top, and it's just beautiful, beautiful application. And I believe it's either gold leaf or it's some other kind of G. Clay process. But I have found more often than not from the previous show at the Velvet Mill that this piece ended up attracting more people to just sit with it than most of the other pieces. Again, this piece, Ooh, Child, by Anne Wildley, is valued at $300 and is a G. Clay fine art print. This piece, also by Anne, is called Tribeca Alley, limited edition of 25, and is G. Clay fine art print, valued at $500. Anne Wildley has, for the past 5 years, I think, at least, as long as I've known her, done more traditional, not traditional, but rather more of an investigation into landscape and urban landscape and the idea of urbanism and some of the beautiful shapes and landscapes and contrasts that she creates. Again, this is called Tribeca Alley. It is a limited edition of 12. Let's see if I can focus here on paper, but the quality of the print is such that it almost looks like an ink application in person. Again, Anne Wildley, Tribeca Alley, limited edition of 25, is valued at $500 by the artist. Here we go. Tribeca Alley, Giclée Fine Art print, $500. As we near the end of the show, I would like to end with these three pieces. And to talk briefly about the artist's response to crisis. As these enigmatic pieces that are absolutely stunning in person are about a familiar crisis that happened in the past. And this series by the artist Catherine Love, my mother, she created these as a response to crisis of 9/11. And this series entitled Exercising Sorrow are watercolor with glue and ash. She painted with the glue and adhered ash to the canvas, which offers a really interesting and stark contrast to some of the thick and thin applications of both watercolor ink and other materials. Interestingly to note, my father, her husband, was five blocks away from the buildings when they were hit, when he was working in New York at an advertising agency. And luckily, he was not harmed and he was able to get out of the city. But I also remember that day and where I was, as we all do, remember where we were. Again, this series, Exercising Sorrow by artist Kate Love, is valued at $5,000 each, or for a set of three at $10,000 in total. I know personally the artist is looking for representation from galleries at the moment and is also looking to have these pieces collected by a museum for preservation and historical purposes. Again, Exercising Sorrow, the artist's response to crisis of 9/11, valued at $5,000 each or a nesting set of $10,000. The size of these is about 4 feet by 5 feet tall, framed, archival paper, UV glass. The subtleties in her drawing allow a certain cushion for the viewer to not immediately be smacked by the trauma of the images that are on the surface, but rather it's after the fact that the audience is pulled into the concept and through their investigation of its surface are able to heal and understand trauma. It is at this point that I would like to thank again our hosts here at the LaGrua Center. For more information about the LaGrua Center, you can find them online at lagruacenter.org. And for more information about me and these broadcasts, as well as future shows, you can visit brightfuturism.com to find a hosting spot for these where they will be archived. Please follow more of our broadcasts and follow this as we start to collect more artists' response to crises and display this work in future exhibits. More information from the artist can be found online in the comments and through our other broadcasts. And with that, I would like to just personally say thank you again to the LaGrua Center in Stonington, Connecticut for having us. I'm your host, Harrison Love. I don't know how to play the piano.
thank you for joining us. Kelly, if you're seeing this, I'm sorry I'm playing this piano, but I'd love to learn it. Just wonderful. Thank you so much for your efforts in editing this video and putting your tags on it. I'm going to send it along to you. I hope that the audio actually comes through clear. And I wish you a good day.